I'm Brent Tharp, Technical Product Manager at Wiffels Hybrids. In today's Corn 101 series, I'm going to be talking about corn growth staging. The first stage or part of a corn plant's life cycle is called the vegetative stage. And the vegetative stage is denoted by leaf growth primarily, and we do the leaf collar staging method at Wiffels, to where we count the number of leaf collars to denote that growth stage. And a leaf collar can be found or defined is a leaf blade that connects to the corn stalk, and there's a distinctive line, and that is a leaf collar. So when we're staging plants at this point in time, we're just simply counting those number of leaf collars. The vegetative stage, growth stages go from V emergence all the way to tassel emergence, so VE to VT, and then the various leaf stages in between. So if we look at a V1 corn plant, V1 corn plant is pretty small, and you can, to where we have one leaf collar on that plant. The first leaf of a V1 corn plant is always rounded at the tip, and all subsequent leaves are pointed at the tip. On a V1 corn plant, the growing point is below the soil surface, and you can see it's often called the crown of the plant, and then that plant is connected to the seed and the seed roots, and the seed roots and the seed are providing the nutrients and water for that small corn plant, and it provides it through the mesocotyl. As we move ahead into a V3 corn plant, three leaves with three defined collars, what you'll see below ground is we have a new root system starting, and that new root system is the nodal root system, sometimes called the crown roots, and the corn plant is going to start relying on that nodal root system from this point all the way up to about V5. And this is the point of time to where there's a transition from the seed roots to the nodal root system. So from V3 to V5, that corn plant's transitioning from the seed roots to the nodal roots. So at this stage, we also want that mesocotyl continue to be healthy, because if we, in a small plant, V1 to V3 plant, if that mesocotyl gets damaged, it can impact the corn plant from that point forward. So when we're staging plants, it's important to know where the growing point is. So in a V4 plant, you can see that this growing point, this triangular point when the stem is dissected in half, is below the soil surface. Now at V6, that growing point has breached and it's above the soil surface. So if you think about damage to above ground tissue, leaf tissue on the smaller corn plant from emergence to V4, you know, the corn plant can withstand some damage to that above ground leaf tissue because that growing point is below the soil surface and can regenerate leaf tissue. So if we get hail or some animal damage or a light freeze, you know, we can lose some above ground leaf tissue and still be fine. But when we get into this V6 growth stage, that growing point is more exposed to the environmental conditions. Now, speaking of the V6 growth stage, that's a very important stage in a corn plant's life cycle. There's a lot of things going on at this point in time. Again, the growing point's above the ground, but also all of the leaf tissue, all of the ear shoots, and the tassel have been determined and initiated in a V6 corn plant. And then also the ear girth is being determined at this point in time. So now we're talking about our yield components, things that directly affect yield. So if we think about environmental conditions that can affect that V6 corn plant, we're really starting to impact yield at that point in time. This is why a lot of our herbicides have V6 growth restrictions for application restrictions. Now, as we move beyond the V6 stage, it gets a little bit more difficult to identify the V stage of the corn plant. And that's because as the corn plant grows and that stalk expands, we'll start to lose leaves. So it's not often that if you go and look at a tasseled corn plant that the first four leaves are actually missing off that corn plant. So from the V6 stage on, you'll need to dig up the plant, split it down the middle, and then you look for these lines, which are the nodes of the plants. And you're looking for the space in between the lines. So here below, or in the crown of the plant, is an inverted triangle, kind of, a lot of times it's a little off color, and it's more hardened tissue. That is the first four nodes of the corn plant that are compressed together. Now, in a smaller plant, a V8 to V10 corn plant, you'll see a little space, probably of a quarter inch, and that's denoting the fourth to the fifth node. But as that corn plant gets bigger, let's say waist high or bigger corn, even that space will be compressed together. So I always look for this internodal space here that's greater than a half inch, and that's going to show us where the fifth and the sixth node is. And that's important because if you can find this sixth node, you can usually find the leaf that is attached to that node, that leaf sheath that's attached right there at that node, and then you can count your collar leaves above that to determine what stage that plant is at. So if you just need a kind of a quick method to determine the leaf staging without having to dig up and split the plants, what you need to do is you just find these roots that are at the soil surface, and if you find those roots, generally that is your sixth node, and you can go on from there. So from V6 all the way up to tassel, the corn plant is in the rapid growth stage. So that corn plant is accumulating, it's getting taller, accumulating more leaves and just more above ground tissue, and also below ground we're getting aggressive root growth from the V6 all the way up to the tassel stage. And depending on heat, we'll usually get a new leaf every 3 to 4 days. And typically a corn plant will have 18 to 20 leaves by the time it is tasseled. So you'll have 18 to 20 leaves on a typical corn plant. Now the important part from a yield standpoint is that our ear length is being determined from about the V7 up to 1 to 2 weeks before tassel emergence. That is the time the corn plant is determining ear length. So any stresses at this point in time in its life cycle can impact ear length. Finally, the corn plant after the vegetative stage, after the tassel has emerged, we go into the reproductive stages of corn growth and development, starting with silking. So whenever you start to see silks on the ears, that denotes the R stages of growth. And then we go all the way up through physiological maturity. And we'll be covering this in another Corn 101 series, more in depth on the reproductive growth stages. So for today, I'd just like to thank you for taking time to watch this video.